Hi students, this is Botany PSR. Today we will discuss a new chapter called Cell Cycle and Cell Division. In this, today I will explain what is a cell cycle, what are the phases of cell cycle, duration of cell cycle in various organisms. Okay, right, all multicellular organisms start their life with single-celled zygote. All multicellular organisms start their life with zygote. All multicellular organisms start their life with zygote. Is that zygote is a unicellular or multicellular? Unicellular. Uninucleate. Unicellular. Uninucleate diploid. It is unicellular. Uninucleate, which is diploid, and it is the product of syngamy. What is syngamy means? Fusion of male and female gametes. Okay, right. Human cell cycle time taken duration is 24 hours. Plant cell 16 hours. Yeast, what are yeast? Unicellular fungi are called yeast. 90 minutes. Bacteria 18 to 20 minutes. So if you take lower to higher means ascending order based on time taken. Bacteria, yeast, plant cell, human cell. The time taken for cell cycle duration in bacteria is 18 to 20 minutes. Yeast is 90 minutes. Plant cell is 16 minutes. Human cell is 24 hours. That is the cell cycle duration, the cell cycle time taken, it varies from organism to organism or from one cell type to another cell type. So cell duration time varies from species to species. True. From one cell type to another cell type. True. It cell cycle duration varies from one organism to another organism, from one species to another species, from one cell type to another cell type. So that is human cell cycle duration is 24 hours, right? That cell cycle contains two phases mainly, interphase, M phase. M phase means mitosis phase, also called division phase. That is, it undergoes division. This word D means division phase. Correct word is division phase, right? So human cell cycle duration is 24 hours. Interphase time taken is 23 hours, and M phase or division phase is 1 hour. M phase is mitosis phase or mitotic phase, also called division phase, 1 hour. What the percentage means? What the percentage of interphase means? 23 by 24 into 100. That is equal 95.83. That is more than 95%. More than 95% of cell cycle, it contains interphase. And 1 by 24 into 100 means 4.17. That is less than 5%. So most of the cell cycle occupies which phase? Interphase. Most of the longest phase of cell cycle is interphase. Smallest phase of cell cycle is human cell cycle. Cell cycle of human cell. Time taken is 24 hours. Interphase 23 hours. M phase 1 hour. So longest phase of cell cycle is interphase. Smallest phase of cell cycle is M phase. Full name mitosis phase, also called D phase, also called division phase. D phase means division phase. Which one occupies more than 95% of cell cycle means? More than 95% means interphase. This is very, very important. Okay, right. Phases of cell cycle. One is interphase, another one is M phase, also called division phase. D means division phase. Here the nucleus does not undergo division. Here the nucleus undergoes division. So that's why here the nucleus does not undergo division means it is a phase of non-apparent division. Non-apparent division. Here the nucleus undergoes cell division. So that's why it is so called phase of apparent division. So interphase is also called non-apparent division, and M phase is also called apparent division. Very, very important points. Okay. Now look at here, my dear students. This is the cell cycle. This is the cell cycle. So this interphase contains three phases: G1, S, G2. This interphase contains how many phases? Three phases. We have to say in the sequential order: G1 phase, S phase, G2 phase, and then M phase will occur. M phase means division phase, that is mitosis phase, right? Let us suppose here it is one chromosome. Here it is one chromosome, and this together called one chromatid. One chromatid. One chromatid contains one DNA molecule. One DNA molecule. So chromosome 1, chromatid 1, DNA 1. DNA strands means 2. Okay, right. Here I have taken one chromosome. One chromosome means one chromatid, one DNA. So what are the important characteristics of G1 phase? G1 phase means, where do you find G1 phase? G1 phase is present in between M phase and S phase. This G1 phase present in between M phase and S phase. In this S phase, DNA replication occurs, DNA duplication occurs. Okay, next one. And what are the important characteristics means, cell is metabolically active. And next one, and continuously grow in their size. Next one, size of the cell increases. Next one, duplication of cell organelles occur. Here duplication of cell organelles occur, that is number of cell organelles will be doubled in G1 phase. Now let's come to S phase. S phase means, where do you find S phase? S phase is present between G1 phase and G2 phase. G1 phase means gap period 1 phase. G2 phase means gap period 2 phase. Okay, S phase means synthetic phase. Which part is synthesized? DNA is synthesized. So synthesis of DNA will occur in, synthesis of DNA occurs in S phase. Now look at here, in G1 phase, one chromosome with one chromatid. Whereas in S phase, this DNA undergoes duplication. DNA undergoes duplication. That is, one DNA becomes two DNAs. One DNA becomes two DNAs. So that is so called DNA replication, also called DNA duplication. Involved enzyme is DNA polymerase, also called DNA dependent DNA polymerase. The DNA replication occurs in nucleus. Okay, so that is one chromosome. Here it is, one chromosome is having one chromatid, one DNA. But here, that chromosome splits longitudinally and form two chromatids. The chromosome splits longitudinally and form two chromatids. When there are two chromatids are present, two DNA molecules are present. So amount of DNA will be double. Synthesis of DNA occurs in S phase, synthetic phase. Amount of DNA will be doubled in S phase. Here how many chromosomes are present? One. Here it is also one chromosome only. Don't say it is two chromosomes. Entire thing is considered as one chromosome. That chromosome with two chromatids. Two chromatids present means that is amount of DNA will be doubled. So one chromosome, one chromosome, one chromatid, two chromatids, one DNA molecule, two DNA molecules. So there is doubling of amount of DNA. Amount of DNA will be doubled in, amount of DNA will be doubled in S phase. Is there any doubling of chromosomal number in S phase? No. Here it is one chromosome. Here it is also one chromosome only. There is no change in chromosomal number. There will be doubling of amount of DNA. This is the very, very important point, my dear students. So, one chromosome, one chromosome. So, that is no change in chromosomal number. That is, chromosomal number will not be doubled in S phase. Which one will be doubled? Amount of DNA will be doubled. Amount of DNA will be doubled in S phase. This is the very, very important point, my dear students. So, one DNA becomes two DNAs. This process is called DNA replication, also called DNA duplication. That is, synthesis of DNA occurs in S phase. Okay, right. Here it will be continued in G2 phase. Where do you find G2 phase? G2 phase is found between S phase and M phase. G2 phase is present between S phase and M phase. Here synthesis of RNA and proteins occur. Synthesis of RNA and proteins occur. Now I am asking, synthesis of DNA occurs in S phase. Synthesis of RNA occurs in G2 phase. Synthesis of proteins occur in G2 phase. And here S phase, histone proteins are also synthesized. If they say histone proteins means, we have to say S phase. Histone proteins are synthesized in S phase. In G1, what are the important characteristics means? Duplication of cell organelles. Duplication of DNA or synthesis of DNA. Here synthesis of RNA and proteins. Synthesis of DNA occurs in S phase. Synthesis of RNA occurs in G2 phase. This is very, very important. See here, let us suppose in G1 phase, amount of DNA will be 2C. Amount of DNA will be 2C. Then what will be the amount of DNA in S phase? In S phase, amount of DNA will be doubled, no? 2C becomes 4C. And what will be the amount of DNA in G2 phase? Continued, no? 4C. Let us suppose number of chromosomes in G1 phase is 16 chromosomes. What will be the number of chromosomes in S phase? 16 only. There will be no doubling of chromosomal number. There will be doubling of amount of DNA. There will be doubling of chromatid number, but there is no doubling of chromosomal number. That point you have to understand. 2C becomes 4C. Here 4C, here 4C. It will be continued. One chromosome with one chromatid. One chromosome with two chromatids. One chromosome with two chromatids. 2C, 4C, 4C. One chromosome, that means 16 chromosomes, 16 chromosomes, 16 chromosomes. Okay. But out of syllabus, synthesis of RNA and proteins occur in both G1 phase and G2 phase also. Actually, synthesis of RNA and proteins occur in G1 phase. It will be continued in G2 phase. But that is not in the textbook. Synthesis of proteins occur in G2 phase. That is the only point in our NCERT textbook. Okay. Now look at it. Based on the occurrence means, based on the occurrence means G1, S, G2 and then M phase. Interphase contains how many steps? How many phases? G1, S, G2. What is the longest phase of interphase? Longest phase means G1 and then S phase and then G2. Based on duration, decreasing order. Based on duration, decreasing order of phases of cell cycle. G1 phase is largest phase of interphase and then S phase and then G2 phase and then M phase. And now look at here, some cells exit G1, some cells exit G1 and enter into an inactive state called G0 stage. G0 stage means quiescent stage. So these cells generally do not divide. When the requirement is there means then only they divide. That type of stage is so called G0 stage. So G0 exit from G1. Some cells exit G1 and enter into an inactive state called G0 stage. What the example of G0 stage means? G0 stage example means nerve cells and heart cells. These cells generally does not divide. When the requirement is there means then only those cells will divide. The stage is inactive, but the cells are metabolically active. G0 stage is inactive stage, but the cells are metabolically active. G0 stage is also called quiescent stage. G0 stage inactive or active stage? Inactive stage. Cells are metabolically active. G0 stage is inactive state. Inactive stage. But the cells are metabolically active. What are the examples that perform G0 stage or quiescent stage? Heart cells and nerve cells. These cells do not divide regularly. When the requirement is there means then only those cells will divide. Which cells are the examples of G0 stage means heart cells and nerve cells. This G0 exit from this G0 exit G1 phase. When the requirement is there means that G0 again enters into G1 and again S phase and again G2 phase and the cell becomes undergo division. Like that you have to take. Okay? Right. Now what are the points come under interphase? That is, what is meant by interphase? The phase that is present between two successive M phases. So that is, between two M phases, the stage is there, the phase that is present between two successive M phases is called interphase. It is also called resting stage or phase of non-apparent division. That is, the nucleus is not in a state of division. But what are the conditions required for cell division? Though they are all prepared in interphase. So that is, many biological activities occur or nucleus is not in a state of division. Nucleus is not in a state of division. So interphase is also called resting phase, also called phase of non-apparent division. What is the reason many biological activities occur? Or nucleus is not in a state of division. Where do you find the nucleus in a state of division? M phase. Right. longest phase of cell cycle is interphase. What are the events of interphase means? Cell growth occurs, DNA replication occurs, cell prepares for cell division. What are the requirements for cell division? All those are prepared in interphase. Prepares for cell division. What are the requirements for cell division? Those are all prepared in interphase. Next, it is divided into three subphases, G1, S, G2. We have to say in the sequential order. G1 phase, S phase, G2 phase. Of these three, what is the longest phase of interphase? G1. Smallest phase of interphase? G2. Okay, DNA synthesis occurs in S phase, RNA synthesis occurs in G2 phase, that is synthesis of DNA, required enzyme, DNA polymerase, synthesis of RNA, required enzyme, RNA polymerase. Those DNA polymerase and RNA polymerase, those two types of enzymes are found in nucleus only, right? Generally, in interphase, the nucleus is in the state of chromatin material, that is long thread-like structures called, uncondensed structures called chromatin. Whereas in dinoflagellates, the nucleus has condensed chromosomes even in interphase. The nucleus has condensed chromosomes even in interphase, and it does not possess histone proteins. Histone proteins are absent. What is that group means? Dinoflagellates. In dinoflagellates, the nucleus has condensed chromosomes even in interphase, and histone proteins are absent. When histone proteins are absent means nucleosome organization is absent in, that is, dinoflagellates, eukaryotes. Generally, nucleosome organization, histone proteins are absent in prokaryotes. Okay, the eukaryote in which histone proteins are absent, nucleosome organization is absent means eukaryotes like dinoflagellates. Examples, Noctiluca, Goniolox. Right, G1 phase, also called gap 1 phase or gap period 1 phase. Where do you find present between M phase and initiation of DNA replication? Where the DNA replication initiate means S phase, between M phase and S phase. Cell is metabolically active and continuously grow. Size of the cell increases. Duplication of cell organelles occur. Next, based on occurrence, G1, S, G2, M phase. With G0 means G1. This G0 exit from which stage? G1. Whenever it undergoes division means again it enters into G1. So G1, G0, G1, S phase, G2 phase, M phase. G1, G0, G0 again, G1 we have to write. G1, G0, G1, S, G2, M phase. Of these, which one is the longest phase of interphase? G1. Shortest phase of interphase? G2. Of course, in our NCERT textbook, this total entire diagram is somewhat wrong, duration. So, please follow this one only. Entire diagram duration is somewhat wrong. So, follow this diagram only. Okay, I think you understood, my dear students. Right, based on time taken, based on duration, G1 is the longest phase, and then S phase, and then G2 phase, and then M phase, both are same. Okay, next, S phase, also called synthetic phase, present between G1 phase and G2 phase. DNA replication or DNA duplication occurs. Amount of DNA per cell or amount of DNA per chromosome will become double. That is, 2C becomes 4C. One chromosome, this is, let us suppose this is one chromosome, one chromatid. It splits longitudinally. Finally, one chromosome only, but two chromatids. Whenever there is the presence of two chromatids, amount of DNA will be double. Next, no change in chromosomal number. No change in chromosomal number. If the cell has 2n is equal to 16 chromosomes at G1, then after S phase also 2n is equal to 16 chromosomes. Same chromosomal number will be maintained. Next, in animal cells, during S phase, DNA replication occurs in nucleus, whereas centriole duplication, centrioles are useful for cell division. In animal cells only they are present. Centrioles are found in animal cells only, absent in plant cells. So, in animal cells, centriole duplication occurs in cytoplasm. In animal cells, centriole duplication occurs in nucleus. False. We have to say cytoplasm. So, those centrioles are duplicated in cytoplasm of animal cells. Don't say nucleus. Right. Histone proteins are synthesized in which phase? S phase. Okay. Next, G2 phase. Gap period 2 phase between S phase and M phase. Synthesis of RNA and proteins will occur. Okay. So, please note down all these points, my dear students, and try to understand. This is one chromosome, here also one chromosome, here also one chromosome. Then what is the difference? One chromatid, two chromatids, DNA. If it is treated as 2C means 4C, 4C. Right. G1 S phase, common character, same chromosomal number, difference. Amount of DNA is half in G1 as compared to S, or amount of DNA will be double in S phase as compared to G1. Next, G1, G2. What is the common character? Similar character between G1 and G2. Same chromosomal number, difference. Amount of DNA is half in G1 as compared to G2. Or in other words, the amount of DNA will be double in G2 as compared to G1. Like that comparison, simply remember one chromosome. One chromatid, two chromatids. One DNA, two DNAs. Amount of DNA will be doubled in synthetic phase. It will be continued in G2 phase. Same diagram. Okay. Please note down all these points, my dear students. Now look at here, my dear students, G0 stage, also called quiescent stage. Example, which cells exhibit G0 stage means heart cells, nerve cells. Generally, these cells do not exhibit cell division. These cells do not undergo division. Some cells divide occasionally. They exit. G0 is exit from G1 stage and enter into an inactive stage called quiescent stage. This G0 exit G1 and enter into an inactive stage state called quiescent stage. Cells are metabolically active. Stage is inactive, but the cells are metabolically active. Cells divide depending on the requirement. When the requirement is there means, then only those cells will divide. If the requirement is not there means, those cells will not divide. That type of stage is so called G0 stage. Example, heart cells and also nerve cells. In our textbook, only heart cells was given, right? M phase, also called mitosis phase, also called D phase, that is division phase, right? Where do you find this phase? Present between G2 and G1 phase. First karyokinesis occur and then cytokinesis occur. Karyokinesis means division of nucleus is called karyokinesis. Division of cytoplasm is called cytokinesis. And this M phase is the most dramatic period. Most dramatic period of cell cycle is very, very important. Dramatic period, that is, looks like drama. That means so many events occur in cell division, one after the other. So most dramatic period of cell cycle is, that is, M phase. Okay, and reorganization of cellular components, all components of cell occurs in M phase. Reorganization of all components of cell occurs in M phase. Most dramatic period, drama, looks like drama. Most dramatic period of cell cycle is M phase, right? Longest phase of cell cycle is interphase. Smallest phase of cell cycle is M phase. Longest phase of interphase is G1 phase. Smallest phase of interphase is G2 phase. Okay, according to you, you please follow this diagram only. Don't follow the NCERT diagram. It is somewhat wrong. Okay, right. Synthesis of RNA occurs in means, synthesis of RNA occurs in actually both G1 and G2 phase. Most better option is G2. Actually, synthesis of RNA occurs in initially in G1 and it will be continued in G2. So that is, if only one we have to choose means, we have to choose G2. That is the better option. Next, synthesis of DNA in S phase. Synthesis of RNA in G2 phase. We have to write only one means, we have to write G2 phase. Don't write G1. If both G1 and G2 means, okay, it is correct. DNA, synthesis of DNA, which enzyme is required? DNA polymerase. DNA polymerase active in S phase. RNA polymerase active in G2 phase. One question I want to ask, amount of DNA and number of chromosomes in G2 phase of cell cycle is, that is, in compared to G1, G2, G1, same chromosomal number, but amount of DNA will be double in. See, if you look at the here diagram means, G1, G2, one chromosome, 2C becomes 4C. amount of DNA will be double in G2 as compared to G1. But the same chromosome number will be present both in G1 and G2. So that is amount of DNA and number of chromosomes in G2 as compared to G1 means amount of DNA will be double in G1 phase. Number of chromosomes in G2 is equal to that of G1 respectively. Amount of DNA will be double in G1 phase. Number of chromosomes is equal same in as compared to G1. Okay. Now, three phases you have to write means correct sequence. That is, first one interphase and then karyokinesis and then cytokinesis. These two together called M phase. Interphase and M phase together called cell cycle. Correct sequence of cell cycle. Okay, so please note down, my dear students, and we will meet in the next class.